Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to the Yas Project. Have you outgrown your friend group? Here's some lessons that I've learned. Roll the intro. Welcome to the All right, so if you just got into self-development, if you're trying to start a business or trying to start anything new, you guys will understand this podcast so much. And it's something I've gone through multiple times. I think life's always about pattern recognition and understanding where you've come from. But I've done this multiple times as well. And I know what you guys are going through, so let's sort of break it down. Bit of context. When I was a kid, I always wanted to play professional rugby league. Had guys on my team that are a lot better than me when we were kids, but I knew if I wanted to get out, I had to do things differently than them. So for me, I was getting up early, going for runs in the morning, in the afternoon. I lived right by my primary school, so I used to go down and kick goals and work on my kicking game or sidestepping or anything like that. All my other friends was kind of just chasing girls and going out to parties. And at the time, the boys were sort of paying me out, going, oh, you're taking it too serious. Come have fun with us as well. And that was the first time I sort of recognized this pattern of for you to do something, you have to be doing something else different as well. And it was the first time that I sort of looked around and you'll learn this. Sometimes you think the people that are closest to you are actually your biggest critics, and your biggest fans are people that don't even know you. And this is just a lesson in growth. Much like when you're going for growing pains, much like when you're going through puberty and you're starting to get a little bit taller, your body starts to ache. That's a growing pain. If you're trying to get fitter and you're going for runs and sort of shit like that, that's a growing pain. It's going to be hard. There's a growing pain there. If you're trying to start a business, trying to do anything out the norm, you're going to get paid out from your closest group of friends. So understand that. This is really key important. If your mates are starting to pay you out, or your family's starting to pay you out because you're trying to grow into a different direction, it's part of the process. It's necessary. You need to go through that to get to the next point as well. Next part, moved into rugby league. I was into different things. I was into reading. I was into taking photos. I was into making videos. All good things that held me in good stead right now. But at the time, when you're a professional rugby league player, not cool to read books, not cool to take photos. I used to walk around with this camera and boys be like, bro, what are you doing? Same thing, as a pattern recognition of going, oh, he thinks he's better than us, or what are you doing that for? That's not what we do around here. You got to be doing what we're doing. That was the second time it happened. Next time, me, Chico, and Norma used to all live together. We used to go home. The boys used to play FIFA. That was sort of my cue. I was like, oh, if they're going to play FIFA, I'm going to shoot upstairs and read. Same thing, like not as aggressive, but they're like, oh, just come down and play with us. Oh, why are you reading books for? You think you're smarter than us. Now, as you start to get older, when you're in high school, you think popularity or you think being cool is everyone knowing you and everyone's cool with you. And as you get older, you start to sort of, you have friends and associates, but there's only certain people that you start to hang around, and you just get less and less and less. And you get to a point where you're comfortable with 3-4 friends, and you're comfortable in your own company, and you enjoy being by yourself. And that's a great part about growing up, because you start to learn all these different lessons as well. Same thing, me, Checo, and Normie started a clothing brand, YKTR. Might have heard of it, hopefully, grateful. Footy boys, no one's going to buy your clothes. Who the fuck's going to buy thing with YKTR from you boys? Pattern recognition. I understood this. I've seen this before. That means I'm going in the right direction. Next thing, start vlogging. Oh, no one's going to watch you guys. Next minute, the boys are hitting us up to jump on the vlog. Same thing, podcast, same thing, sports media. So what I've recognized when you're trying to outgrow your current circles right now is that you're going to get some outside noise, and it's always going to be from those closest to you. And sometimes your biggest fans are just going to be strangers and people that don't even know you. The nicest DMs I've got from people on Instagram, from people I've never met in my whole life as well. So like I said, understanding part of your growth pain is getting bagged by the people that are closest to you. Now, you don't have to get rid of your current circle straight away. Make sure your day ones, make sure those who are the most loyal to you aren't keeping you in a day one mentality. And it's just not like all about loyalty. Like loyalty is understanding, like you want to grow as well. You want to be better. You don't want to be doing the same shit a year from now, 2 years from now, 5 years from now. You don't want to get old and have that fucking big regret. Wish I started that business. Blah, blah, blah. You don't want regret. Now, here's what I do. Or here's what I used to do. I learned this thing called the law of 33%, which basically means you split up your time into thirds. So the first third is spend people on the same level as you. So for me, say Chico and Normie, people understand our relationship. I don't need anything from them. They don't need anything from me. It's just mutually beneficial. And with that, I'm just trying to chase good times, laughter, friendship, potentially a shoulder to cry on sometimes, neutral. Next part is spend time with people smarter than you. Now, if you don't have a parent that you look up to, or a relative that you look up to, or you have mentors that you have access to, spend time with books, spend time with podcasts, spend time on YouTube. There's an abundance of free education out there. Now, the thing with mentoring is you just need to find one guy that you can relate to, one guy that kind of looks like you. He doesn't have to be someone over in America living in New York trying to make $1 billion. He could just be some guy that's potentially from your hometown or someone over from you as well. Start to absorb their information and you can learn from them. Pay attention to how they're speaking, how they're acting, and you start to grow from there as well. Read books. Some of the greatest people, some of the smartest people of life have written books, and you can buy them for $20 as well. So first third of your time, people on the same level as you. Second third of your time, people that are smarter than you. And the best way to do that is through technology. Audiobooks, books, podcasting, anything along those lines. When I wake up in the morning, I try not to get jump on social media straight away. I kind of just post my time that I wake up, and then I just listen to people that are smarter than me. First thing, I don't listen to news, I don't listen to media or anything like that. People that are smarter than you, soap your mind. Get people that are smarter than you into your brain straight away. Last part, helping people. Spend time that are probably less fortunate than you. And it doesn't always have to be charity-based and going down and donating things, clothes to the homeless and stuff like that, which is something we do as well. But for me, I just do it through podcasting. People want to ask me questions and blah, blah, blah. If I can do it through this way, I'll press enter and it goes out to the world as well. Now, it doesn't even have to be that hard. You might have a little brother and he might be 13, 14, and you can see him starting to stare off in a different direction that could potentially be trouble. Spend time with him. Show him the right path. Spend time potentially with your kids as well. Show them that you're a great dad or a great mother as well. So it's a great way to divide your time. Law of 33%. So when I first went in, I sort of felt like, oh, I'm outgrowing these people, so I just need to go find a whole new circle. And you can do that, but then split that across your time. Because there's time when you hang around smart people, all you want to do is come back and talk a bit of shit with the boys as well. And then sometimes if you're not balanced too far that way, you just want to go back and help people because it makes you more grateful for the situation that you're currently in as well. So that's a great way how I spend up my time. That's how I break it up. But it is important. Understand these key facts. If people are paying you out, it means you're on the right path of growth. And split your time up in threes. People on the same level, people that are smarter than you, and people that are less fortunate than you, or someone that you can help. And that's a great way to spend your time. Last thing, like I said, when I was a little bit younger, and as you get older, you start to lose your friends, and not lose your friends, you're more selective of who you hang out with. Now, the key is to try and find people that cover two bases as well. Now, the dream is obviously to find people that are on the same level as you, and then people that are smarter than you as well. And the reason why you do this, you do hang around less people, you hang around more diverse people. You might hang around people that are well-traveled, well-read, well-experienced in life, and they might be the funnest people that you hang out with. For me, I like hanging around these two 60-year-old guys that have done a fuckload in life. I just like to sit there and talk and listen and ask questions. And once you get around mentors, don't talk. Shut up and listen. So, yeah. That's my thoughts on Outgrowing the Circles. Hope you guys liked it. See you guys next time.